line with the ongoing 40th regular session of the United Nations Human Rights Council, two NGO briefings were held at the UNHRC headquarters in Geneva today. One of the briefings was organized by the Indian non-government organization Pasume Thaigam Foundation, which saw the participation of TNA parliamentarians M.A. Sumandaran, S. Sridharan, as well as Northern Provincial Councillor M.K. Shivajalingam. During the meeting, AdaDerana reporter, who was in attendance at the time, was requested to leave the meeting room by members of the Tamil diaspora. Meanwhile, members of the Global Sri Lanka Forum organized a protest opposite the headquarters of the United Nations Human Rights Council in Geneva yesterday against Sri Lanka co-sponsoring the fresh resolution presented by Core Group on Sri Lanka as well as the UNHRC Resolution 30/1. Sri Lankans residing in several countries, including the UK, Italy, France, Germany, Poland, Sweden and Dubai, gathered opposite the UNHRC headquarters yesterday.
We all know that resolutions are not binding, but we have to comply with all the recommendations because we have co-sponsored it. As it is now, America has withdrawn from the Human Rights Council, stating that it's a cesspit of political bias. But still we are carrying on. Whatever the balance recommendations, they have been included in the rollover resolution by United Kingdom, and that too this government recommended, and then they accepted that. One of the recommendations was the OMP, Office of Missing Personnel Act, and it has been approved undemocratically without a vote. They can accept which are not normally accepted according to the evidence ordinance. They can collect all the false evidences against whom they want to charge. And because we are under universal jurisdiction, they can be arrested abroad. And also we have already signed the enforced disappearance bill. And if the country concerned request, these war heroes can even be extradited. That is how this government has let down the war heroes and also the nation.